Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Chanute Community Sports Complex. And tonight's game featuring the visiting Pittsburgh Purple Dragons and your Chanute Blue Comets. While enjoying this evening's scrimmage, remember that this is our this performance. Remember that this is a tobacco-free facility and usage is not allowed within the confines of the complex. We want to thank parents and small children for supervising their tonight's contest. I want to thank everyone in attendance for leaving our designated disabled seating areas open for our disabled guests to use. Before leaving this evening, please help keep our community proud by picking up any trash in your area and properly disposing of it. Activity programs, we remind you, at Chanute High School are primarily for the student participants. The purpose of this activity is to provide a positive learning experience and opportunity for personal growth of the participants. We're pleased to host our guests from Pittsburgh. Competition is being conducted according to the rules of the Kansas State High School Activities Association. Cheerleaders, officials, and spectators can and are expected to assist in the promotion and achievement of good sportsmanship ideals by taking personal responsibility for keeping this contest at a high level of fair, clean, and wholesome competition. Good luck to both teams, and thank you for your cooperation. We also want to remind you about Community National Bank for sponsoring a pass. That's going to be held during the halftime. Tickets are available for purchase during the first quarter of tonight's contest, either from our Blue Comet Bowling student athletes in the stands or at the concession stand. Two tickets are going to be drawn during the second quarter for a chance to win two field goals at halftime. First prize is $50 and second is $25. Thank you, Community National Bank, for sponsoring this event, and thank you to everyone who purchases their ticket for the Community National Bank Kick for Cash.
Good evening, and welcome to Chanute High School football. It's week two of the football season, and I'm here. My name is Dave Rimbold. I'm here to do play-by-play. I'm here with Coach Chad Graham. Coach, how are you?
Wonderful. What a wonderful, beautiful night, Dave. Come home and get ready to watch after a wonderful game last week out on the road. See what the Comets have to bring for the hometown crowd.
Yep, should be a, you assume it'll be a tougher game, although Pittsburgh had a lot of graduating seniors last year, and they lost their first game at home against Emporia. Hard to draw any sort of conclusion from that. Emporia is a big school, so they might have a pretty good team. There's just no telling, but we're just used to Pittsburgh being a power in southeast Kansas, so we assume that it'll be a tougher test tonight for the Blue Comets, but certainly I would say the Blue Comets would be favored to win, although, again, it's hard to tell the
as they were warming up, seemed to be equal size, Dave. It was both teams about numbers and size of who's going to be playing the starting line, D-line.
Yeah, Chanute coming off a win over Augusta last week, and Augusta was coming off a 7-4 season, but pretty young, starting a lot of juniors and skill positions. So we'll see what happens tonight. Right now, it just kind of feels good to be back at what Mike Sutcliffe so tenderly dubbed the Cosmosphere.
It's beautiful to be at home and looking out east with the sun behind us and as the sun starts to go down.
So we're back home in Chanute, ready for week two. If we're talking keys to the game for Chanute, let's go over some just from a very general sense.
We need to set the tone defensively. You set the tone with tackles and set the line of scrimmage, and offensive zone. Last week we seemed we struggled getting the run. So I think the one with running the ball with Leedy and Harding, who I think that would help spell out the our passing game.
Yeah, yeah. Certainly the timing issues in the running game last week. The pass game looked pretty solid.
Awesome.
Herb looked calm and collected, just was delivering everything. It looked like the guys on the outside, Teamster and Dagan, the Dean Weaver, could get open anytime they wanted to. That's my nickname for him, by the way. And if I don't sing it, then it doesn't count.
It don't sound right.
Dagan Dean Weaver. His name's not Weaver, it's Dean, but you know what I mean. Just get open anytime they wanted to last week. And Herb delivered the ball so well that, man, it made the passing game for Chanute look really, really easy. I assume that'll be a little bit tougher test this week. Pittsburgh probably has a few more leads than Augusta does. And we'll see if the passing game can continue to do well. I think the big question mark for Chanute is mainly defensively and on the line, somewhat on the offensive line. You know, it'll be interesting to see what happens. They can give the sort of protection they were given great protection last week.
He had all the time in the world, and I think that's maybe why our passes were so pretty. I mean, I think one pass that hit the ground in the first half last week.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have the total stats, but
yeah, and so the offensive line did great last week. So from a standpoint of, I think the defensive line, like, you know, that was the key. So we are about to have the Star Spangled Banner, the national anthem. So we are going to let you enjoy the sounds on the field for that. And we'll be back in just a bit.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like for you to please rise and direct your attention to the northwest corner of the field for the presentation of the colors for tonight's game. Presenting the colors for tonight's game are Larry White, Charlie Warren, Randy Haynes, and Frank Robard from the American Legion Post 170. this time, we ask that you remain standing as we honor the United States of America with the playing of our national anthem by the Chanute High School Band, under the direction of Dr. A.J. Blue and Ms. Rebecca Lauder. We remind all in attendance that the proper etiquette is to remove your cap or hat, face the flag, and stand with your right hand over your heart. You may notice active duty military personnel or veterans not in uniform saluting the flag. Please sing along on our national anthem. Thank you. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is a pleasure to introduce you at the north end of the field, Coach Clint Gazelle and your Chanute Black Comets!
Getting ready for football. The teams are out on the field. The Blue Comets versus the Purples from Pittsburg. Looking over Pittsburg's roster here, a lot of juniors, Coach. Looks like another young team for Chanute across the field from them on week two. Not a whole lot of seniors. We'll see how that works out. Of course, last week we did mention they lost to Emporia, but only by 3 points. Looked like a tough, close game, and so I'm expecting a tough test here for Chanute tonight.
It'd be interesting. We don't know how the JV did last year. They played a lot. They were senior heavy last year, so they could be slow bringing it together, or it could just take one game or two games to get their stuff back together. But we got our starting offense tonight. X receiver, Tartar, J receiver, is Seamster, left tackle Anderson, right guard, or left guards Love, center, Axelson, right guard, Jacket, left guard, Thurston, the big man. We've got A receiver is Dillon. Wide receiver is Dean. Quarterback is Herb, and running back, Levy.
Your captains out there, Eric Herb, Trey Dillo, Ty Levy, and Caden Seamster, or excuse me, Dagan Dean. So they're out there for the coin toss. Also, I'm going to have to ask that when you refer to Daxon Axelson, that you refer to him as Daxon Battle Axelson.
Battle Axelson.
Battle Axelson, yes.
I got that. Battle Axelson.
He works hard at the G&W, the little grocery store here. So I talked to him a little bit the other day. Good kid.
What did he have to say about today?
I don't know. I didn't ask him about today. I just told him good game last Friday.
All right.
But he's a good kid.
Yeah.
Working hard there at the G&W.
Have a job and play football and go to school. That's dedication.
He's a throwback, for sure. He's a throwback.
Nice.
So the sounds like they will get the ball first, or did they defer?
I didn't see we were talking, Coach. All right. Or Dave.
Well, we weren't. Okay. We'll find out in a second as we are ready to get this game started out here.
We're definitely receiving.
All right. So the Blue Comets will receive the ball. It means they will get the ball to go going the direction they want in the second half.
Correct.
Yeah.
I lied.
Yeah, you didn't get that right, Coach. No. They're kicking. Okay. So Chanute won the toss and deferred. And the Purple Dragons will receive back deep. We'll try to get their names learned as quickly as we can. Connor Prophet, sophomore, back deep to receive, along with looks like number 39, maybe it's 38. I can't quite tell from here.
We've got Jackson Vaughn gonna kick for the Comets tonight.
Yeah,
he
so
put it about the 10-yard line, 15-yard line.
Well, he wasn't the kicker last week. It was Brian.
I thought it switched.
So we're going to see a different kicker tonight, at least to start the game.
Wonder if we'll kick PATs tonight.
We'll see what the strategy is here with the new kicker. It is a short, high kick. It's fair catch, was called for by an up man, but he didn't get it. So the Pittsburgh Purple Dragons, and he has a lane. He's got it down the sidelines. Couple men to beat, and he's not going to beat them. And we're going to get a face mask tacked on to the end of that. And so Pittsburgh's going to have great field position to start off the game here.
They set their wall, and when you call that fair catch, and they got it right behind him, that was pretty.
Yeah, so what's the ruling on that?
I'm having a hard time. I think that's.
And the up man called for the fair catch, and the guy made the catch right behind him. Yeah.
So it was like a distraction. And so I don't know. To me, that seems like that would be a penalty, distraction.
Well,
there should have been a ball right there on the 20.
They maybe just missed that at any rate.
Maybe the back judge missed it.
Pittsburgh gets the ball on the 41. They've got two wide receivers and one tailback. Quarterback under center, he turns and gives the handoff up the middle, and a nice push by the Dragon offensive line gets him about 3 or 4.
It'd be interesting, the Comets defense right here, if, like we talked about last week, you can bend but don't buckle. Defense didn't have any control where they got the ball, but they got control of what happens right now.
Yeah, second down and maybe 6-7 yards.
I'd watch the wide side of the field.
Here's the snap, and there's quarterback option, and he pitches out at the right time, and it's a good play for the Purple Dragons inside the 30. Gain of about 9. So Pittsburgh coming out with their running game on the first two plays, and they have a first down to show for it.
In a 4-3 defense, the DN's got to kill the quarterback on that play so that it doesn't get that kind of yardage.
Now the quarterback, a slightly different formation here. Two wide receivers to the near side. Man in motion to give up the middle, and he's brought down by a gang of Comets after about a 3-yard gain.
Getting a little physical out there. Got a receiver taking the corner down.
Yeah, Eric Herb hit the deck.
Way out of the play. It's a severe option.
Second down and seven again upcoming, or maybe six.
Be a good time for the D to make a good stop right here. I wonder if the D coach call any stunts.
Quarterback for Pittsburg, I believe, is Webb Fern. He's a junior.
The Will linebackers
now
out.
A fake pitch, and he's going to try and run it. And
good stop.
Another decent gain, though, coach, and they're up to about the 20-yard line.
Looks like third and two.
So third down. This could be four down territory, though, for sure. The Purple Dragons.
You would think.
So third down and three, we'll call it. Fern up to the line.
Line opposite.
He's been under center every play so far. He's got a man in motion. Here's a snap. It's another option play. Here's the pitch. No one out there. Some running room. One man to beat. He won't beat him. And Quinton Harding finally brings him down inside the 10, or right at the 10. Well, now they're going to give him the 9, maybe. So first and goal upcoming here for Pittsburgh.
Seamster came up to make that hit and got taken to the inside. That's why they got the extra few yards.
Pittsburgh running a older style of offense that you don't see as much these days anymore, but it's highly effective.
Double.
Fern under center. Running back behind him is Heenan to give it to him. Excuse me, that's number 23, and he's wrestled down. That is Wyatt Rink, another junior.
He hit a brick wall there, Coach. Or Dave.
Still gained a couple, and it's going to be second and goal from the 7. See if the Blue Comet defense toughen up after being given a short field here on the first drive of the game.
Tonight, you got 9 small playing right. And
two receivers to the far side. Fern under center. And in motion again. Here's the snap. It's a pitch out to the left, and he escapes the tackle, but the next man brings him down, and we got a flag
in
on the play.
In.
It hit an offensive lineman or a wide receiver, excuse me, so we may have a holding here. Oh, no, he's looking at the Pittsburgh coach. This is going to be a penalty on Chanute.
No.
Nope.
It's
okay.
It was holding on.
He was just delivering the call to them, maybe.
Yeah, you're letting them know.
Well, there's a holding on the Purple Dragons. That'll send them back, and it'll be replay second down, second and goal. And it's all the way back at the 16-yard line now, and a little extra room. Sometimes this can be bad for the defense, though. You spread out the field a little bit again. The defense actually has an advantage in the smaller field as far as if they have to pass, especially.
Yeah, now they got a little more room to cover.
Is the man in motion? It's a fake pitch, and he's back to pass. Boy, that ball was almost deflected, but somehow got him. It's a
how
good
he
catch
under his arm. Small almost knocked that out of the air.
They get back to what was the original line of scrimmage before the hold, almost. Maybe a yard short of that, and it's going to be third and goal from the 8.5-yard line.
Comets have to make a stop here, Dave.
Big play upcoming. If they get,
I think we got to.
They get a few yards. You think they would go for it again on fourth?
Be interesting to see what the D coach calls if he calls any stunts.
Fern taking it. It's going to be the quarterback optioned out to the halfback, and he scores.
Locked in, untouched.
A nice option play. That was Connor Prophet on the pitch, and Pittsburgh takes the lead here early, 6-0. Tough start for the Blue Comets. Jackson McKechnie out on the field for the extra point attempt. Snap was high, but and the kick is up, and it is good, and Pittsburgh takes the early lead, 7-0. We'll take a 30-second break and be right back. So Pittsburg with the early lead. 7-0 over Chanute. We'll see what Chanute does with their first possession of the game. Pittsburgh was aided by a return and a penalty. They started that drive somewhere around the inside the 40 of Chanute.
Which I'd still be interesting to look up that call. But it'd be we didn't get to see the return team much last week. The Augusta kept onside kicking because they were behind. So it'd be to see what we do on special teams too.
McKechnie's a good kicker, so he sends one deep. So we're going to see a return right here. Ball comes down to Leedy. He's got it. Moving up the field, and he's across the 20 before he's wrestled down at the 24, 25-yard line.
There was a great block set, or he would have been stuck at the 15.
So Blue Comet offense will take the field, and we'll see if they have a little bit better timing this week. Although, what do you think, Coach? Do you think they come out throwing here? They came out kind of dedicated to the run.
It'd be interesting to see because of the film that we had from last week.
Here comes the offense, Herb, the quarterback. And, of course,
Pittsburgh's
four wide receivers.
4-3.
Trips to the far side. Herb in the shotgun. Here's the snap. Herb, a little quick swing pass out to the wing. And it's a good gain up the sideline for Caden Seamster.
There's an answer.
A quick throw and catch. And a gain of about 5 yards.
Looks like if they did that play again, we'd have a quick screen on this wide side of the field. He was wide open. And he's a specimen of an athlete.
It's true, Coach. Second down and 5 upcoming. Seamster and Tartar to the near side here. 4 wides is kind of their base formation. Here's the give to Leedy, following his blocker. Following and pushing and gain of about 7-9 yards before he's finally pushed out of bounds. What a run by Ty Leedy.
His legs just don't quit. He says, I'm going to run you over tonight.
Well, we talked about this last week. He's so short. He gets behind that big offensive lineman. And he's just, you can't, it must be so hard to just even see him. He just kind of ducks his head and hides, and then he just follows him. So you got to tackle, you're going to end up tackling Gus Thuston and Ty Leedy. That's not fair.
I guess that's the average how the pros make it, 5'9", 5'11".
First and 10 for the Blue Comets. 4 on the play clock. They got to get set and go. 2-1. Here's the snap. Herb, little quick screen. Oh, and Seamster just dropped it. Boy, that was a good play set up there. As again, physicality happening there by the receivers and the blocking.
It's there. Pittsburgh is definitely doing some hitting.
The Chanute player for his purpose gave him a pat on the back. Say, hey, just playing football.
That was a great call by Frizzell. Looked like he was going to go for at least had it. It went through Seamster's hands.
Second down, you bet. Boy, he had some room to run.
Yeah,
had a nice
two
little
great
lane.
Blocks by those receivers.
7:07 to go here in the first quarter. Second down and 10. Chanute finds himself 7-0 after Pittsburgh short field got on the board first. Herb back to pass. Little quick pass and catch, gain of a few.
To Dillard.
Oh, no. They say incomplete. Incomplete pass, so that must have skipped and hit the ground.
That's an interesting call.
Third and 10, and now Chanute needs to. They need a big play here. Third and 10. They'll unleash their receivers and ask their offensive line to. The first test of the game really is like hold this and create a pocket for Eric Herb.
Here's a question. What if they get 7 of the yards?
I'd go for it. All here's right. Herb waggling out to his left. Now he's going to tuck it and run. He's got a man to beat if he wants that first down. Last little effort, and he may have it.
They gave it to him.
Nice run by Eric Herb. Very fast for a quarterback on the field. And he gets the first down with his feet.
Dave, he kept that ball to where he could pass it until he knew he was past the scrimmage, and then he tucked it and ran. He was looking downfield the whole time for his receiver to open up.
Herb's he's a smart quarterback. He does a lot of things with his head and his eyes to keep the defenders guessing until the last minute. first and 10 just across midfield. Trips to the near side. Here's Herb, the handoff to Leedy, following a blocker. He's got a lot of space. 45, makes the man miss, 40. Now finding more room, cuts it back to his left. He's dancing all over the field without a partner, and finally down at the 31.
That was some footwork. One thing about it, Dave, once he got past his corner, made a great block coming back for him. You got to be careful that you don't, because some of your people start to try to catch and get a good hit, and sometimes that's when you get the block in the back that you didn't need and lose all that great yardage.
You don't usually see that out of Ty Leedy, but no. I think he thought he had a lane back to the left there. At any rate, it's first down and 10 after a great run. And now Herb coming over to the sidelines. And there's play clock just now started, so plenty of time. Base formation looks like for the Blue Comets here. Four wide receivers, Leedy in the backfield with Herb.
Pirates are playing power line, they're switching sides.
Here's the give to Leedy. Leedy trying to follow a blocker, bounces off a man, but then he hit a nice that big line, wall.
That linebacker read that play and stayed home.
Still, he got a gain of 2 yards and make it second and 8.
They're moving their two big D linemen, D end and D tackle, to the. They're swapping sides.
Under 5.5 to go here in the first quarter. Blue Comets trying to answer a first drive score for Pittsburgh. Herb's got the snap. He's looking to pass. Now he's got a man over there on the right side. Makes the man miss. Dagan Dean brought down at the 5-yard line. Oh, big game
nice.
For Dagan Dean Weaver.
That song. Herb had all the time in the world that we were talking about like last week. So I think the offensive line showing that they love that pass protection. How do you sit back on your back leg and keep your pumping your back leg?
Developing story, Coach. Gus Thuston just limped off the field. They can't afford to lose him on that right tackle spot. First and goal upcoming, though. They got to keep playing. There's no one really attending to him. I think he maybe just tweaked it, hopefully.
Bruised or some sort.
Going under 5 minutes here in the first quarter. First and goal.
Bet you we see a couple shots of Leedy.
Maybe even a quarterback draw. Here's Herb with the snap. It is the fake handoff. Now a quick pass to the outside. It's Dillo. Did he get in? Yes. Touchdown.
Nice play fake right there.
6-yard touchdown pass after the play fake from Herb to Trey Dillo. And the Chanute Blue Comets are on the board. And look at this.
Frizzell's calling some great plays.
They are getting the extra point here, Coach, after going all 2-point conversions last week. So a new kicker out on the field. That's Jackson Vaughn. He'll try to put this one through the uprights.
He did kick the extra points for us last year.
The snap is down all as well as a flag. And the kick is good, but we'll see what the penalty is. It's a procedure. So it looks like they're going to have to re-kick this extra point. So they'll move him back 5 yards.
I wonder if the holder moved, because there's the white hat called that.
So now it's going to end up being what amounts to a 25-yard extra point here. As Vaughn will reset to put this through the uprights. Here's the snap. Kick is away. It's a line drive. Did it go through the uprights? It did. And this time the extra point goes through. Well, Chanute ties it back up 7-7. We'll be back in 30 seconds. So 7-7 tie, 4:40 to go here in the first quarter. We'll see which one of these defenses can collect a stop first. During that timeout, Gus Thuston was getting his ankle re-taped up, so I would say we will probably see him returning to action. I just tweaked that ankle a little bit.
It's hard to play in the trenches in there without getting.
Here's the kick by Vaughn. It's a high kick, taken at about the 11. That's a good kick.
Yeah.
We'll see if the Blue Comet special teams can do a little bit better. It's a big hole at the middle, but a flag down.
That'll be coming back.
So the return goes out to about the 43, but we'll see what happens here as a flag is laying on the 22.
Holding Pirates.
Dragons, but close. Dragons. It was a different
Pittsburgh,
mythical character.
Sorry. Not bad.
It is a penalty against Pittsburgh. And so this will put them deep. This will be a different situation there.
Our special teams are getting there. Have to get off that. They're making a four-man wall.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to have to either hit that wall and smash mouth it.
Well, you could tell me, maybe, as I'm not a football player. I wasn't a football player. But it looks like we're playing a little more hesitant than last week. Maybe in our minds that Pittsburgh's a little tougher opponent, and little butterflies, maybe home opener. They just need to unleash.
Yeah, let's turn it back up.
First and 10 for Pittsburgh from the 13-yard line. Fern under center. He's got a man in motion, and
that's two people.
Appears to be
that was two
audibling.
People moving.
And yeah, we're gonna get a penalty on Pittsburgh. Well, there was, I don't know if he was audibling or what he was doing there. They're actually going to call delay a game as the play clock ran out. Well, that was a weird play there from Pittsburgh as there was some confusion.
They were
see many delay a games on
the,
first down.
They were going to motion him back into the eye, but.
Well, here they come out again. Now first and 15 inside their own 10.
Same setup.
Fern turns. Keeps it now and a little option, and this time the Blue Comets make everyone
smashed.
Pay. The fake up the middle hit, quarterback hit, pitch man hit. That's how you defend an option there, coach.
And then Leedy.
What a great defensive play. I think someone, do you think someone on the sideline just said, hey, if you're going to hit someone, hit them?
Yeah. It seems like we turned it up. Like, yeah, you said we needed.
Is he, if you're going to run that triple option, then make all three of them pay.
Yeah, that's what you got to tackle them all.
Second down and long.
The Purple Fern. Dragons, bring them all in close.
Yeah, tight formation here. He's back to pass, though. He's looking,
first
looking. Here comes
the
rush. Pass to the side. It's bobbled and dropped by the Pittsburgh receiver. Boy, that hit him with some little room to run there. So little.
He hit him on the go. That receiver just let it go through. We had covers.
It's a good break for the Blue Comets.
He would have gained probably 9 yards, but Quentin Harding was going to lay him down. He had to let up.
Third and long here, deep in their own territory is Pittsburgh. This is a pretty key defensive play here for Chanute here with 3:45 to go here in the first quarter. Tied 7-7. Fern in a passing situation. We'll see what they let him do. He is back to pass. He's looking. Here comes
the sack. There's a safety.
Was it a safety?
Yes, it's a safety.
Their officials are discussing it. That was Dagan Dean. And it is
the white hat.
Fourth down. They say
he's down. The white hat gave it on the 6-yard line.
He is inside the one. Dagan Dean Weaver from the defensive end position on the blitz.
Oh, I thought he had him 2 points to match his number.
Fourth and a long way now. And now you got to, you wonder if you bring the, bring the blitz
you bring
to try and
heat.
Block the
you
punt.
You bring the heat. Because the punter could step out of bounds, and that's a safety.
He's standing with his heel, I'm guessing, inches from that back line. He took a step
that
back.
That should have been a safety.
Now the ball hits the turf, and Chanute will get it from about the, well, looks like about the 50-yard line.
Sorry, Comet fans. We don't have the replay running, but it sure looked like he took a step back. That should have been a safety like Dean's, but we can't play the officials. You just got to play football. What a great drive by the Comets.
Well, we said which defense,
defense
is going to step up and get a stop first. And not only did they get a stop, but it was dominating possession for the defense. And that is how momentum is won, Coach.
I think it was set.
So 7-7, 2:53 to go here in the first quarter. The Blue Comets just marched down the field on their last possession. Now they've got less than half a field. Gus Thuston back out there on the right tackle. We'll see if they get him some work early here. Here's a man in motion that seems to run into that right direction. Now he's following Gus Thuston.
That linebacker.
6 yard gain for Seamster.
He ran with finesse. He waited, and he was gaining it. He saw it coming. He didn't try to.
I don't think you can guess wrong if your guess is, I'm going to look for big 75 and run behind him. Yeah. Because the wheels on the Gus go round and round, Coach.
I think the whole line, you know, Battle Axel must be doing his job up the middle.
Second down and 4. Trips to the far side on the short side of the field, Coach. We'll see what happens here. Herb looking for a man. He's got a Ty Leedy on the swing. Makes the man miss. Nice little juke. 30. Dragon tacklers down to the 25. That's an all-state competitor right there in Ty Leedy. State champion wrestler.
I wonder if Herb, I don't know if Herb didn't see him, but.
He had a man deep.
Carter was down. He was 10 yards past his guy. I just don't think Herb saw him.
Yeah, it seemed like that play was designed to go to Ty from the beginning.
From the beginning, I agree.
Down and 10 now from the 25 of Pittsburgh. And Chanute rolling. 4 wide receivers. Pittsburgh going blitz. It is a handoff to Leedy up the middle. Inside the 20. Nice gain of about 7 yards on first down.
You have to give that to the Comets O-line. The Purple Dragons had their whole defense up on the line, knowing that Leedy was coming up the middle, and we still gained 6-7 yards.
It bodes well to see that push from the offensive line here. Now, young Quinton Harding into the game for Ty Leedy. The sophomore, 5'10", 171 pounds. See if he gets an opportunity here. Under a minute to go here in the first quarter. Herb's got the snap. He's back to pass. Boy, an easy pass and catch to Dillo. Dillo inside the 10. First and goal upcoming.
It's pretty hard to cover for a good receiver. Pretty evenly, spread out. Yeah. You could choose either one, any of them, and they're going to get good. They have good. Confident hands.
Yeah, Trey just found open spot in the zone there and just sat down, and it was an easy pass and catch. First and goal from the 9. Harding still in there at tailback. 4 wide receivers. Base set for the Blue Comets. Here's the snap to Herb. It is the give to Quinton Harding, sophomore, picking away up the middle. He's inside the 5. Dragon tacklers. Finally gang tackled. The sophomore dragging the defense for the Purple Dragons.
Our running backs are like the locomotion. They just keep their legs going.
That is going to probably be the end of the first quarter here. It's tied 7-7, but your Blue Comets are driving inside the 10. We'll be back.
KFEX Fire Escape Radio programming is made possible in part by the underwriting efforts of Sonic Drive-In of Chanute. Sonic Drive-In of Chanute does not consider community involvement a sales gimmick or a public relations ploy. They see it as a way to...
Welcome back. First play of the second quarter is second and goal for the Blue Comets. They're in a tight formation. Herb under center. Lots of guys. Here's the give. The running back is Leedy, and he runs over a defender to get into the end zone. Touchdown. Chanute Blue Comets take the lead.
He got in the end zone untouched. He didn't get tackled till he was in there.
I like to say he was on the line just so we can say we ran him over.
Okay. He was on.
It makes it seem cooler.
Yeah, you make it sound a lot better, Dave. You're more experienced at that.
13-7 Chanute. Out comes Vaughn for the extra point. Snap. It's down. The kick is up and good.
Interesting to see the Purple Dragons all standing up in two-point stance. It's hard to get low and get leverage when you're standing up.
Yeah. Chanute leads 14-7. We just started the second quarter, so we'll just keep it right here. And offense just keeps humming along, and that's a good sign for the Blue Comets.
Well, the defense made that great stop. Set the tone, and then the Comet offense just marched down the field, what, six plays and put it in the end zone.
Yeah, as we said, boy, when that defensive stop happened and the way it happened, you could almost feel the huge momentum shift, Coach. And we felt it in that time, and boy, the one thing Pittsburgh had to throw up some sort of deterrent there, and they just can't. And the Blue Comets just kind of continuing what they did last week, Coach. Right now, they look pretty much unstoppable.
Doing what they want?
Yeah. They're absolutely doing what they want. They can run the ball. They can pass the ball. Passing looks easy for them. I mean, it seems like every receiver Herb throws to is wide open.
Frizzell's definitely got the O-line making that. It's called you take your strong step back and you make a shoe for the quarterback to stay in the pocket. Because he's not getting pressure. He's getting pressure he wants to throw to.
So the Blue Comets, the only thing that's been an adventure for them so far is the special teams coverage here. So we'll see if they can tighten that up as Jackson Vaughn set up on the tee.
If they can blow through this four-man, it's a three-man wall they make back here.
Here is Vaughn with the kick, and it is a pooch kick up in the air. Nobody realizes it's going to hit the turf. It's up for grabs, and it goes out of bounds.
Oh.
Flag goes down as that will be a procedure penalty because the kick went out of bounds.
That shouldn't be a foul. The white touched it. We touched it.
We'll talk about this one maybe. They are discussing it, so it's your right, Coach. They're going to talk this over and see if someone touched that ball.
Both teams touched it.
It did look like there. It was off a lot of hands. As it stands now, the ball is marked at maybe the 25-yard line. They are going to mark off the penalty.
Must have been only our guy touched it.
It did look like the Chanute, the one guy that for sure touched it was. No worries, though. The ball will move up about 5 yards, so not a huge play. And the Purple Dragons will start with first and 10 from the 35. Webb Fern, the junior, brings his offense back out onto the field. There's a man in motion. It is a fake pitch to him. Fern back to pass. Look, he's got no one to go. Now he's being chased, and he gets a couple good yards out of that. Nice play by the quarterback. Well, he was running for his life there, Coach.
Dean almost knocked that ball out of his hand as he reached to make that tackle because the quarterback still had it just out.
Gain of 4 for Webb Fern. And, boy, for the way that was looking, everybody covered on that play, Coach.
And we had plenty of pressure. The quarterback just stepped up and gained 4 yards.
Second down and 6. Early on here, the Chanute rushers have made their presence felt. Fern under center. It's going to give to the running back, first guy through, and he's wrapped up and thrown down by Ty Leedy.
That's a state champion wrestler.
That is a wrestling move.
You're not getting through here.
Is that a point? I don't know wrestling.
That's a 2-down. That'd be freestyle. That'd be a 4.
Yeah, the only wrestling I know where the guy does an interview and goes, "Yes, brother." 3rd down and 5 upcoming here.
Well, Leedy would be saying that after he threw that. be a nice stop if we stop them here.
Quarterback under center for the Purple Dragons. Here is an option play. The pitch to the outside. Harding. Oh, nice cutback by the running back. Got him close to the first down. And he looks like he may have it.
Depends on where the oh, they're giving it to him.
Connor Prophet made a great cutback there, coach, that probably got him that first down because the defense was there. The blockers didn't give up either. That was
they're having an official argument. The guy that spotted on our sidelines holding his foot on the 44, and he's making them move it back to measure it.
So it's third and half a yard. But yeah, sideline judge overruled.
Yeah, he said, no, this is my foot.
And so it's third and inches.
Usually don't see the sideline official overrule the white hat.
Pittsburgh going to go for this. So big play for Pittsburgh. Get this. They're really behind the eight ball.
We got to send the linebackers.
Here's the snap, and boy, we got some whistles.
Got some motion.
That looked like there might have been a timeout before that. Timeout Pittsburgh, and that's a good thing, Coach, because you're right. I think there was all sorts of movement going on. And so Pittsburgh will talk about it. We'll take a 30-second break. You're watching Comic Vision. Four to go here in the first half. Chanute leads 14-7. Pittsburgh facing fourth and about 2 inches from their own 44-and-a-half yard line. Here comes the play.
I think it's a quarterback sneak. Well, we definitely got our two D tackles in up on the A gap. Motion.
Here's the snap. It is a give up the middle, and boy, a lot of running room. Whoa, one man to beat, and Trey Dillo makes a touchdown saving tackle.
He went to the C gap. We had linebackers and D tackles going A and B. Nice pop out by that running back.
Pittsburgh is a capable running football team, Coach. And boy, that was a great, great call and a great play there. And a great tackle by Trey Dillo to save the six. First and 10 now from the 44. Chanute. Here's Fern, and now we got flags all over the place.
The receiver on this side was lined up offside, I think. They called it motion, in motion.
Oh, penalty on Pittsburgh will set them back here. And last time, they started off the a set of downs with a penalty. It didn't end well for him.
He was offside.
Well, that's just a mental error.
Yeah, he was the outside receiver, lined up close. He didn't look over to the line judge to ask him, I lined up right. But we're not complaining.
No good. First and 15.
Want to see some pressure by the Cummins? I'd like to see a sack.
Here's Fern, back to pass. Quick pass over the head of the wide receiver, number 42, Gabe Kimsey.
He had to let it go.
Gabe was running up the seam there, but
his pocket isn't staying around him.
And Kimsey was open there, I think. Rushed the pass.
Yeah, he threw it. Yeah, I agree. He was open. One thing nice to see is both our free safety and strong safety are not letting any of their receivers get deeper than them. They might be open, but they're not going to get a free touchdown.
That's true, Coach. The boy, there were guys there to make the tackle. Should that have been completed? Second down. And 15. And now we've got more whistles.
Look at the line. The ball's a foot, a yard in front of the stick. He moved it.
The referees are. There you go. You got it. Crowd gives a Bronx cheer. Second and 15, not 14. Here we go.
So the officials have to work out their cobwebs also.
Option play, quarterback finally pitches it. Oh man, I thought that halfback was about to get pasted. And he got to be able to, he just got enough of a time, enough of a second to get out of the way of that big hit.
And Tater, gain of three. Tater was flying to smash him right before.
Yeah, they are in mode option play, coach.
Yeah, they don't want it to beat him again.
Well, if you're going to beat him, you're going
to do it.
That got hit again. And it's third and long now, third and 12. Interesting to see what
they had
they play call here.
They've had two passes close.
So Fern, yeah, he's gone back to pass a few times. We'll see if they let him pass here. He is back to pass. Now looking to swing. He got hit
and
after
he
threw.
Smashed,
and the defense is up to the task. That's going to bring up fourth and eight. Boy, the quarterback paid again. Digging Dean.
Yeah, you didn't sing it.
Yeah, well, you know, you can't sing it every time he makes a play. I'll lose my voice.
Dean leveled him. That was a great hit.
And the punting unit out onto the field for Pittsburgh.
Wonder if the Comet will put pressure or go back and try to gain ground by blocking.
There's some big, big kids back there in the midfield there. Here is the snap. The punter has got it, and he kicks a nice high ball
short.
And land and take a Chanute. Now bounce to the side, and
25.
Pittsburgh downs it right at the 25-yard line, and that's where Chanute will take over. We'll take a 30-second break. We'll be right back. You're watching Comet Vision. All right, welcome back. First and 10 for the Blue Comets from their own 25-yard line. Herb in the shotgun, trips to the far side. Now he's running, gambling, got some blockers. 30, 35, 40, 5th, 45. Finally pushed out of bounds. Comet, or excuse me, territory.
None of those ugly yellow flags out there on the grass. Awesome run.
Who's got the whistle out there? I keep thinking I hear an official whistle.
I thought I heard an official whistle that was going to stop that play.
Someone thinks they're funny. Big gain by Herb, and he did it with his feet this time. Had a play like that earlier. First and 10 from the Pittsburgh 42. And in motion is Seamster. It's a fake to him. Give to Ty Leedy, who's pushing a defender back.
Look at that. He gains five, and he had all four of their D linemen on him.
Ty Leedy is special, coach. He is special.
I'm saying something about the O-line and the comments.
I think gravity affects him twice as hard as the normal human because it says he weighs 162 pounds, but he's like 162 pounds. He plays like he's my size, coach.
So you're saying it pulls him north and south?
And I think I'm eating more cheeseburgers than second down and 6.
You think he goes to the end zone, coach? Dude?
You hate to see it. You don't.
Yes.
But let's go.
He's gonna.
Pump fake. Herb again.
Oh,
flushed out.
Pressure,
and he's going to do it with his legs again down the sideline and kicks it out of bounds inside the 20. Well, Pittsburgh having a tough time. When they do have good coverage, they can't contain the quarterback. It's how do you stop this offense, coach? How do you stop it? Oh, that's how. A penalty.
That dirty yellow towel.
A penalty on the line of scrimmage will bring the Blue Comets back.
They called a block in the back.
Taylen Haynes into the game. As Caden comes out, takes a break.
And that's a rough, those are one of those rough penalties you take because usually it's probably right behind where your quarterback got free or your running back. And
yeah, that's a big play.
Big penalty. That's a 55-yard penalty.
Brings up second and about 22, 23 yards. So we'll see what they pull out of the tricks here. Two running backs. Did this last week a little bit with Harding and Leedy in the backfield. And here is the give to Harding. He's got a wall of blockers. He's picking his way up the field and reaches out there. That was a dangerous reach by the sophomore as he was going down trying to get that extra yard. Sometimes that extra yard, not worth it.
Well, 9 of the 11 were downfield right with the running back. That's good to see.
Big, good gain on a run on second and long. He gets about 10 yards. So Harding back off, and they'll go back to the four wide receivers, I'm assuming. So trips to the far side. Lots of space over there. That's the long side of the field.
Is this Dean out here by himself?
Here's Herb. He's waggling to his left, looking down the field. He's got a man. It's Seamster. Makes the man miss, and he'll have the first down. Nice and catched. Herb on the run to his left.
And he's right-handed, throws over.
Make it look easy. The receiver seems to be open, and Herb delivers an accurate ball.
We don't get tackled on the first hit ever. Not very often do they go down on their first hit.
First down for Chanute on the 31.5 yard line. Boy, the chain gang is all sorts of confused over there. He signaled first down. I saw it, Coach. Can't, no take backs. First and 10. Here's the snap blitz by Pittsburgh, and boy, they called the right play at the right time, and Leedy is stacked up for a yard loss. It was one of those where that was the first time tonight where the timing, late flag, and we've got a man down. Is that going to be a foul on Pittsburgh after the play?
Starting to get chirpy out there, I bet.
Be a shame for Pittsburgh after making a good defensive play if that penalty's on them, but the umpire were writing something down here.
It's either a foul because they're right in.
It is an unsportsmanlike conduct. Well, that's a big play, and boy, that's a killer for Pittsburgh as they get a loss of yards for Chanute on that play, and someone came up there and late hit.
It's not their first one, so that's.
Coach calls it like he sees it. Just calls it like he sees it. So big penalty, and Chanute finds themselves now in the red zone because of it. First down. We're under 5 minutes to go here in the first half, and this has been a time-consuming drive here for Chanute. Trips to the far side. Dagan Dean all by his lonesome over here.
Split way up.
Boy, that looks juicy, Coach.
Yeah, the corner's playing him, so the slant's not there, though.
Yeah, the corner's trying to scoot back now. Herb now fakes his quarterback draw, and he's wrapped quickly. And so Pittsburgh is bringing some numbers.
They were looking for that play.
I don't know. Boy, that fade might have looked pretty good there.
You got to blitz when you get down. You got to blitz.
Loss of 4 on the play, second down and 14 upcoming. So has completely helpless in these situations. Defense have made some big plays here and there.
That corner lined up perfect on that. Dean was all the way out to the sideline.
Herb in the shotgun as always. Here's the turn and the handoff to Leedy. Got a wall of blockers and he turns it up the field inside the 15. And a good gain there for Ty to make this third down much more manageable. Gain of maybe 8 yards. We got a flag in, and this is a hold on Chanute. Oh my goodness. They move him back again, flag with on the field. So it's just basically going to be a replay of second down. Maybe lost a couple yards in that equation. Well, penalties will kill you, Coach.
They do. They kill your they kill the mojo. They kill your momentum.
Clock continues to tick here. Less than 3.5 to halftime. Trips to the near side. Herb's got the pass, and he's looking. Kid as he throws. Connected. Smash. Dean into the defenders and down at the 10-yard line. Woo!
I mean, Dean tackled, but he took three down.
Yeah, he's a big. And 6'4".
Definitely a D1 prospect.
So third down and short upcoming. 3rd and 3 yards. Big play for both teams here. Chanute leading 14-7. Blitz coming again. Herb gets rid of it quickly. Passes. Oh, it's down and goal upcoming. Now it's getting wise. Seeing that blitz coming, calling quick hitters.
And Dilla's sitting in that little spot, 5-7 yards, and that's his fifth pass, I bet.
So first and goal upcoming. Pittsburgh runs a couple D-backs off the field to get some bigger kids in there.
They're going to take that play clock down to zero, I bet.
Tight formation for the Blue Cats. Got those two blockers ahead of Ty. Here's the snap, the give to Ty Leedy, and he's falling forward. He's going to be kept out of the end zone, but gain of a couple down to the 2.
We could do that one more time and then put it in.
you're aiming for the clock.
Yeah, we're, I mean.
Second and goal, 2. And Chanute to take a 2-score lead here just before the half. Here's the snap, and Herb pushes on the quarterback sneak. Did he get enough of a push? Seems like half the pile's in the end zone. We'll see what happens when they unpile them. It's a touchdown ruled by the official. Eric Herb with the 2-yard quarterback sneak. And Chanute runs up the score now to 20-7.
It's hard for a common move. 1 yard.
Line pushing up the field behind Daxon Battle Axelson. My guy.
He got the yard we needed.
Here's the kick on the way, and it is good. Chanute takes a 21-7 lead, 1:24 to go before halftime. We'll take a 30-second break and be right back. Welcome back. Chanute set to kick this one off. 1:24 to go before halftime. They've just taken a 21-7 lead over Pittsburgh. Here's Vaughn. It is a deeper kick than the last one, although still going to hit the turf and bounce towards the playing field.
That wasn't a very smart play. I'm sorry about that.
Yeah, I mean, the Pittsburgh player probably got confused by the ball bouncing back towards the field, but still looked like it might have ended up out of bounds. But I don't know if you got to make a quick decision there, Coach, because they were coming for it.
Yeah, that's 15 yards, though.
So first and 10 for Pittsburgh from the 25-yard line, 1:24 to go, and we'll see what they choose to do here with junior quarterback Webb Firm. They have let him drop back and pass several times tonight.
This is key word of the defense. We don't let him have no yards. Beautiful full moon coming up over the horizon over there.
His man in motion's going to be that pitch quarterback outside. Option. Good blocking for the Purple Dragons, but the defense up to the task as Ty Leedy pushes him out. Ty Leedy been all over the field. Gain of about four.
They gave him four, five.
Pittsburgh in their hurry-up offense here as we go under 110 to play. Second down and a short seven. Here's Fern back to pass. Little quick slant, and the ball is caught across the 40. Makes a couple men miss, and then he's upended at the 46-yard line. So 56 seconds to go as the clock stops to move the chains.
We can't give him too much. We can't play back soft.
Pittsburgh has two timeouts. Yeah, that was a good ball delivered by Webb Fern. Here's the play, and it's a fake pitch. Fern back to pass and just got that ball away before Dagan Dean got to it. The right tackle for Pittsburgh is frustrated. He's slapping his hands together. And that'll be second down and 10 off the incompletion. I don't think that'll be the last right tackle that Dagan Dean makes feel that way this year.
They need to bring a running back in to help stop him if they want to complete a pass.
41 seconds to go, second down and 10. Pittsburgh on their own 46. They've got enough time, but pass. Here comes the rush again. Boy, maybe a hold on that play.
That's got to be.
No flag down as Dagan Dean was being dragged down. Instead, the quarterback has to scramble. He gets about 8 yards. Timeout, Pittsburgh, because third down upcoming, 30 seconds to go. My goodness, coach.
We got to blitz our wheel backer on that. Because the guard and the tackler are taking Dean, and there's a wide open lane straight to the quarterback.
Yeah, Dean had had the right tackle beaten. He had nothing he could do besides
hold him.
And he did. Yeah. And no flag was thrown. As we look at the replay here, and my goodness, Dagan Dean has been a monster on the defensive side of the ball here early. Officials are resetting the game clock to 32 seconds. So Pittsburgh off of this timeout, facing a third and three across midfield. More importantly, there's only 32 seconds left when they have one timeout. So Fern, Webb Fern, the Pittsburgh quarterback, he's a junior. Been pretty solid for the most part tonight. He's under center, he's back to pass. He's looking, has to make a quick throw, and boy, it's behind the receiver.
And they called that complete.
The receiver went to the ground to make the catch, but
they gave it to him.
Stops there. Now the clock stops to move the chains, but then it will start running as soon as they get the chains and the ball moved. Now the play clock goes. 23, 22, first and 10. Fern back to pass. Here comes Dean again, chasing him out, and has to make a quick throw, and that's incomplete. We'll chalk that up to the pass rush.
Back to what you're saying about that quarterback. A junior who's been on the ground 90% of the plays.
Yeah, he was.
And he's still staying in the pocket, still staying collected.
He's been solid. Been solid, coach, for what he's being asked to do right now. Second down and 10, 15 seconds to go here. Now things get a little dicey for the Purple Dragons time-wise. Three wide receivers for Pittsburgh. He's back to pass. A little quick pass again. Flag down.
Got a flag down in the
pass
middle.
Is complete. But we'll see what this flag is.
It's interesting. The Purple Dragons are running the same formation that the Comets run as their main offense.
It is a hold on that offensive line. Well, that offensive line is just begging to get a few seconds for the quarterback to have enough time to throw the ball, as the Blue Comets have pinned their ears back here in this last drive of the first half. That's going to send them back and do massive damage to Pittsburgh's chances here.
I think your battle man just went in a D tackle.
Axelson in there on the defensive line. Second down and 20. Now for Pittsburgh as they move back all the way across the 50 on their own side of the field again.
Be interesting if this guy looks over nasty.
Tight formation, so they're showing run. Now we have a whistle. Boy, this is an official timeout, and again, the officials are going to talk something over. had a rough go of it as well here this evening. They make sure they just get it right.
Do they have a coach in the official room that helps them fix out their problems? Now key to this is our corners and our safeties can't let anybody get behind them. We got 11 seconds to go. You can let anything happen in front of you, and you just got to stop it.
So second down upcoming here as the officials linebacker, get it sorted out.
We got middle linebacker even scooting back. We've got five back.
11 seconds in the first half. Pittsburgh a long way to go. Here goes Firm. Here comes Dagan Dean getting blocked by two men, and that pass is off the mark. Incomplete. 1 second on the clock. So now Pittsburgh in a situation where I'm guessing they're going to run some sort of screen or draw play and hope something amazing happens.
They haven't had time to have a quarterback pass. A running back pass.
The quarterback has been on the run. They put two men blocking Dagan Dean, like you said, running back helping out, and he still almost got to him. So this will be the last play of the first half, barring a penalty. And now we've got another clock stoppage and a timeout for Pittsburgh. They want to discuss this miracle play they're working up. We'll take a break with them. 30 seconds. We'll be right back. You're watching Comet Vision. So 1 second to play here in the first half. We'll see what miracle play the Purple Dragons came up with over there in that timeout. Chanute will go way back in a prevent-style defense.
Let's see if Bert and Jack can get any pressure from up the middle.
Webb is under center. It is going to be a drop-back pass, and here comes the rush.
He's on
it. And he is brought down, and what a perfect way to end the half with our man, Dagan Dean Weaver.
He was lined up on the opposite side. He was lined up on the wide side. He's been on the left side.
That'll work for you. That first half for Dagan Dean, that'll work for you? Oh, my goodness. All over the field. And the Blue Comets lead at the half, 21-7. Get ready for the halftime show. Enjoy it. We'll be back in just a little bit.
Lovato, confident, and a smashing hit from Bon Jovi, It's My Life. tonight's performance will be the CHS fight song. Please stand and come along with the band Chanute at the conclusion of the show. Directors of this band are Dr. A.J. Hugh and Ms. Rebecca Lauber. Your drum majors are juniors Aaron Maddy and Ava Campbell. Drum majors. And the field is yours. Thank you, field directors, Aaron Maddy and Ava Gamble, and Dr. A.J. New and Ms. Rebecca Lauder for the Chanute High School Band. And now, ladies and gentlemen, if you would please direct your attention to midfield as the Chanute Blue Collar Cheer Team will perform a routine they learned at camp. The cheer team is coached by Zoe Stewart. Team, your music is on. And now, ladies and gentlemen, one of the moments you've been waiting for as well. Community National Bank, Kick for Cash. In a feature, just down the street, from Home Savings, the Fighting Croutons, kicker, Chris Wilby. Like a young Tenerudish type form out here. McGrinkle. Kaboom! Oh! Just under the uprights. Make him kick one more. Representing for the Home Savings Fighting Croutons, Chris Philby. Kick it, Chris. One more kick. Let's go. Let's go, fans. Get behind it. Kick it, Chris. Kick it, Chris. Kick it, Chris. Oh, shields. Don't let him out. so easy. Back him up one more. Back him up one more. And now to show that Community National Bank what's up. Chris Bubby. Just earned $50 and $25 respectively. Listening to some great music here on Game Time. Remember Blue Commons fans. Student athletes represent their teams, fellow students, teachers, and their school community. Athletes are expected to be individuals who will make a good impression for their schools. Another Game Day tune is coming up here on Game Time.
Now we're at halftime. Chanute leads 21-7. You are enjoying the lovely sounds of the Slim Shady. This won an Oscar, you know. Won an Oscar for Best Original Song. Did you know that?
I didn't.
Oh.
Thanks for sharing.
Well, you know, that's what I do.
You know a lot about the radio and sports, so.
21-7. The Blue Comets lead it at halftime. And, Coach, boy, they've looked pretty dominant on both sides of the field at times. If you're Pittsburgh, are you lucky you're only down two scores here? Do you feel good about that?
Well, you know, there's those two passes that went right through their receiver's hands. So I'm sitting here as a defensive coach going, well, they had their opportunities.
Yeah.
Just a couple missed. They missed up.
Well, and Pittsburgh scored on their first possession with a short field, about 30 yards. That's all they had to do. And Chanute looked a little hesitant at first, maybe. But, boy, once they started, it looked like, so that first drive, Pittsburgh comes out, they're running that triple option. It's looking good, it's hitting. And the next drive, Chanute comes out with the way that I was always told you play against the triple option. Make them pay. Quarterback pitches it, you hit him.
You hit him every time.
Yeah, you hit him every time until they're the ones who are being hesitant.
Yep.
And boy, that happened after that first drive. Pittsburgh still moved the ball here and there, but not enough in between some mistakes they were making. Their youth kind of showing through in the first half on offense, made some mistakes, got some penalties. No turnovers, though, for Pittsburgh, so they've been good on that front. But it's been the Blue Comets who've been pretty dominant. They'll get the ball here first, Coach, to start the second half.
Their first score was definitely by where that field position was at inside their own 40 on their way in by that crazy fair catch. Be interesting still to see if that was a penalty. But the key was when they had them pinned in the 10 and you said the defense has got to turn them up, and they pinned their ears back, and that was the rest of the first half.
Seamster and Leedy back to receive the opening kickoff for the second half.
See how the front line does to get stop five of the Purple Dragons before they get down the field. He kicked to the 5-yard line last time, his first kick.
McKechnie, the kicker for Pittsburgh. Here is the kick, and it's a short one. Ball received at the 12-yard line. Here comes Leedy. Leedy's got a hole, grabbed and tripped up as he crosses the 30-yard line. Boy, there was a lane there if he could have escaped.
That was a good coverage tackle by the Purple Dragon outside. I don't know, he looked like a linebacker or running back. Caught him from the side. I wouldn't say he caught him from the back, but had he slipped, it was a lane to the end zone.
Ball set down at the 31-yard line, first down and 10, upcoming to start off their first drive of the second half. We got Tripp, three wide receivers. They're doing that double running back set with the sophomore Quentin Harding in there. Here's the give to Harding. Harding following Leedy. Now turns it upfield and pounds through a few Pittsburgh defenders for a good gain on first down.
It'd be neat to see him do a couple of those plays and then do a cross buck.
I don't know what that is. That sounds like a hunting term.
One running back comes across the quarterback's face, and then the quarterback hands it off to
like
the other
guy. Oh, like a little
guy.
Misdirection.
Yeah.
Second down and a short six.
Our O-line's moving a guy that's 6'2 and weighs 295.
Here's the snap and the give to Harding again as he runs over his own blocker this time, gains a couple. That one, the handoff, the timing looked a little off again as they had a lot of that last week. They unpile the pile, and it's third down and short. Be about 1 yard, third and one upcoming. So Chanute comes out with a running state of mind. Keep Pittsburgh honest. They pretty much done whatever they wanted to do in the passing game.
Let the clock keep rolling.
Double running back set again. Here is the fake handoff. Herb waggles out to his left. Now he makes the throw to Leedy, who's got the catch. First down and more. Make the man miss.
He will not go out of bounds.
No, he will not. And he's into Pittsburgh territory.
It looked like we had Leedy and Seamster going across 10 yards apart. Leedy was ahead of him by 5, and he could have threw it to either one.
So first and 10 upcoming from the 44-yard line. And Chanute moving the ball again. Same formation. Two running backs. Herb hands off to Ty Leedy this time. Leedy following some blockers. Now cuts it back to the inside at the last second to get a couple yards.
Like I said, he ain't going out of bounds. A lot of running backs would have just took that 2 and said, that's all I'm getting.
Well, Chanute, is this one of those areas, Coach, when they say, hey, we're going to work on something here?
Yeah.
They ran this formation a few times last week, but that was the first time we've seen it multiple plays in a row. Now it looks like we're going to have a more of their standard set as Ty Leedy goes to the sideline. Quinton Harding stays in. We got trips to the near side in Seamster, Dillo, and Dean. Here's Herb, back to pass. Now this play is broken, but he lets one fly over everyone's head. He just threw that one away, Coach.
The Purple Dragons read that from the get-go. That was a step back quick screen, and that corner just stepped. When Dean stepped back, he went with him, and it was broke from the beginning.
Boy, Herb, such a smart quarterback, though, Coach. He if it's not there, he's not going to try and force it in there, and he just chucked that one out of bounds. Brings up third and eight. Chanute blessed with a quarterback who says, I'm just going to not make a mistake. Four wide receivers, trips to the near side. Now we got some whistles as the play clock never got reset. Now it's reset. Urban the shotgun. He's back to pass, looking, got time. Now he's got to scramble a little bit. Runs it up the middle, 40, 35, a lot of room, 15, out of bounds. Sorry, that was the 25, not the 15. I got excited. Now there's a flag in the backfield, though. It looks like this one may come back.
Oh, no, not a holding in behind him.
We'll see what it is, a hold on the defense.
Oh, it's on defense.
Okay. It was an interesting place where that flag landed.
It was on a receiver out here wide. I didn't. That was kind of, even though it was a scramble, it looked like a draw. He made it look so natural.
First down and 10 now for Chanute on the 25.
We saw this formation like five times last week, maybe six, but.
Here's the handoff to Leedy. Leedy picking his way up the middle.
He had nothing and got nine. That is a great play.
So just weaving his way up the field. And a good first down run there by Ty. He's just 1 yard short of the first down, so we gain a nine. Under 9 minutes to play here in the third quarter. Chanute with the opening possession. Here's Herb. Herb gives off to Ty Leedy. Leedy stacked up. He'll lose a yard here. So Pittsburgh defense has at times been able to stop that run.
Looked like the Purple Dragons had three coming through a hole there. We just didn't have enough guys to cover them.
That's going to bring up third and two now after the one-yard loss. They bring in Harding again, so they'll be running that two running back set. Chanute breaks the huddle. They're running it out of that shotgun formation. Three wide receivers. Here's the snap. Herb gives to Leedy. Leedy trying to pick his way up, makes a second effort, and is going to get the first down because of that. Pittsburgh's defense was there and up to the task, but Ty Leedy made a great cut and second effort and got the first down.
It looked like they had him, and he took that little sidestep, waited, and then got the 3 yards.
Yeah, it's just he makes these – he's so patient, and yet when he puts his head down and decides he's going a direction, man, he accelerates so fast. Makes him a hard and deceiving. He's deceptive at running back. His speed is, because it looks like he's just kind of jogging out there until he hits it.
And then it's lightning.
First down and 10 from the 15-yard line. And now we've got a timeout for the Blue Comets. We'll keep it right here, Chanute. We'll talk about it. I think the play clock was running down. Of course, we're here, Coach, on working in tandem with Comet Vision. I am from KFEX, Firescape Radio 93.1, program director there, and we do the morning show. And we should mention our underwriters as they help with the, what we do and the youth ministry at the Fire Escape Coffee House. So Labette Health, Dr. Grant Gastineau, Home Savings Bank, Cleaver Farm and Home, Medicine Shop, Community National Bank, Cardinal Drug, and Jared Gilmore and Phillips. They all help us out there, underwrite the station, and as well as A&W in Iola and Living Word Assembly here in town. So they all underwrite the KFEX Firescape Radio, and that's how we're able to be here.
It's awesome how the coffee house is opening up Friday and Saturday night for places for kids to go and call.
Yeah, after the game, high school kids can go hang out at the Firescape Coffee House till 11 p.m. It's a great, safe place for your high school kids to go every Friday and Saturday night. Tomorrow night, they got a back-to-school party from 7 p.m. to midnight. Band playing, free. Here's the play is a pass out to Seamster, and that's incomplete. They can bring up 2nd and 10.
Seems like those short passes just out to the flats, just the Purple Dragons are covering it. We got to get them stretched out again.
Yeah, it's, we keep waiting for it, Coach. They haven't really done that, any kind of down the field shot tonight like we're used to seeing. And you wonder when it's going to happen, as Pittsburgh is taking their chances on those up balls. Keep waiting to see Dean. He towers over his defender. Now here's the run to Leedy, following his blockers on the right side, carrying the pile down inside the 10 is where I think he ended up. They still didn't bring him down, Coach.
He's not still now.
We're going to see Ty Leedy on the carry.
It's going to bring up third down.
And four.
Long 4 yards.
Stop the board progress. Almost
assuredly two down territory here, though. Four down territory, two plays here to get the first down or a touchdown. Herb runs back out to the huddle. Let's see what they decide to do here. Do they run behind Big Gus on the right side there? We'll see. Herb's got the snap. He's back to pass. He's looking to the outside. It's caught. Seamster reaches for the pylon. Oh, they say he's short. Boy, he knocked over the pylon, Coach.
Pylon is the goal line.
We'll watch that one on the replay. That was the farthest away as it could possibly be from our vantage point. So it's hard to see, but, boy, he reached out. At any rate, it's going to be first and goal, and this is probably a fair call as I'm looking at the replay. But it's first and goal inside the one. We may see another Eric Herb quarterback sneak here.
The comments of 5 minutes and 40 seconds off the clock.
Yeah, they've been
this one drive.
Yeah, they haven't. It's not been the big play tonight, Coach. It's been these methodical drives. Here is the give to the tailback. Did he get in? Pittsburgh may have tripped him up and stopped him, although he's laying inside the end zone.
Right,
that's six.
It.
Touchdown. Ty Leedy. And Chanute takes a 27-7 lead now on the first drive of the second half. Jackson Vaughn out to kick the extra point. Going to attempt his fourth of the night. Kick is up, and it is good. Boy, those officials take their time on that call, don't they? Like, what are they waiting for? My goodness. Boy, the kick went through when there was only one Damon Wayans. Can you get your hands up in the air, please? I'm sorry. I'm okay. Chanute leads 28-7. We'll be right back.
Looks like Vaughn could kick maybe 35, 40-yard field goal if we needed one.
We'll see.
Maybe even farther, but that went clean past the track.
So 6:09 to go here in the third quarter. Chanute with a commanding 28-7 lead. Vaughn set to kick off here.
Really like to see the special teams go down and smack. We're not going to kick it
deep. Pooch
kick
this time. I'm pretty sure the fair catch got called and spotted this time as they blow the play dead at the 27-yard line, and that's where the Purple Dragons will take over.
And then I still don't understand that catch. Had that bounced out of bounds, that gained 8 yards. I mean, it's only 8 yards, but
yeah,
got that 1 yard off the out of bounds line. But it could have bounced the other
way,
I guess.
Yeah, I think you probably tell them, hey, so you can, like, if you can catch it while putting your foot out of bounds, now that's a penalty too, right?
Yeah.
They teach you that. Here is Fern Webb handing off up the middle, number 23. He's got a nice gap up the middle and gain of almost 8. That was number 23, Wyatt Rink. Rink has had a couple runs like that up the middle. The offensive line for the Purple Dragons just kind of overwhelming the defensive line for Chanute on that play. Second down and 2. Here is Fern pitch out to the outside, and now running back trying to cut back to that first down stick, and looks like he may have got it.
Looks like the official's going to give it to him.
But Wyatt Rain.
That was great play by Comets to stay on him, because that was a good fake dive up the middle.
It's a first down for Pittsburgh. Or is it? Yes, it is. First down and 10 for Pittsburgh. Here is the give to the tailback again, and this time he's got less room, although he carries the pile for a good gain. Gain of about 5.
Not very often Leedy misses, but he had him at 2 yards.
Called a long 5 yards, second and 5. We have gone under 5 minutes to go here in the third quarter.
That might
have
been Dillo.
Fern under center. A little different formation there. There's the give up the middle, and again, good fighting by the running back, and he'll be stopped short of the first down on this one. Gain of about 3.5 or so. That'll bring up third and short.
They're testing to see if we're going to stay home, if we're going to follow the motions.
Yeah, maybe see if our defense expected them to panic a little bit and take to the air, and Pittsburgh, for what it's worth, staying committed to that run. Third down and 2, but the clock continues to tick. Tight formation again here for the Dragons. Here's Fern fake. Now quarterback option as he pays again, and the running back is stopped short of the first down, and oh my goodness.
Great play, Comets.
Chanute has played that option so well since the first drive. And the quarterback and running back both paid for it and didn't get the first down, and that brings up 4th down and 2. See, the first hit was Quentin Harding on the tailback.
Coming up from safety.
So 4th and 2, big play here. Pittsburgh has any hopes. They need this first down. Here's the
quarterback
fake pitch, and it might have been a busted play. Oh, no, he escaped.
And he got
from
the first Dagan down.
Dean and the first down.
He had it.
Dagan Dean couldn't bring him down. And now a first down for Pittsburgh. Ty Leedy walks off the field a little gingerly. First and 10.
They stay in this tight formation.
Give to the first man through, and he's down quickly after a gain of 2. Well, they've moved the ball here in the second half on this drive.
That was Jackett and Burt on the tackle there.
It has been Wyatt Rink for the Dragons. Junior, 5'7", 155 pounds. Very similar in stature to Ty Leedy. Gain of only two there, though. It's second down and eight. Here is another give to Rink. This time a good gain, and he's going to be a few yards short of the first down. Another blue comet gets up a little gingerly. This one is number 59, Garrett Love. Hunter Burt runs on the field, a senior. It's third down and three for the Purple Dragons. We'll see what they draw up on this play. And it is a quarterback option again, and boy, the quarterback just
Dean comes all the way across the field and makes that tackle for a loss. Well, they gain one, but
brings up fourth down, and the quarterback just continues to take punishment on that option.
Yet he tosses it right to the running back every time.
That time it was number 46, Cash Fitzmaurice laying the hit on Webb Fern. Fourth down in the yard. It's a big play upcoming for both teams. Here's Fern under center, gives it the first man. No, he keeps quarterback keeper, and it's a good play as they had Chanute fooled. Fern on the quarterback draw. Faked that handoff up the middle and took off to the outside, and a big gain for Pittsburgh. Gets it down to the 30.
He has to have the most yards for the Purple Dragons.
So Pittsburgh put together a nice drive, but it's taking time as we're going to go under 30 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Here's the snap. It's another quarterback draw. The pitch is made to the running back. Good cut back by Connor Prophet. Looked to be the runner on that play. No, that was Grant O'Doherty, excuse me.
We can't be sitting on our heels. We got to start keep coming forward.
So another first down run for Pittsburgh.
15 seconds.
Under 10 seconds to play here in the third quarter. Here's the first down play. It's another give up the middle. This time the Chanute defense is, looked like initially they had a good wall up there, but the running back kind of broke through and got about 4 yards, and that'll be the end of the third quarter. At the end of three, 1 quarter left to play. Chanute leads Pittsburgh 28-7. Come on back for the final quarter. All right, quarter number four, about to get underway. Second down and six upcoming here for Pittsburgh as they drive inside the red zone here. Here's a quarterback option, and he's gonna keep it and get wrapped up and tackled near the sticks for the first down.
He's short by a yard.
So Pittsburgh is, after going down three scores, come out here with a pretty solid drive, but it's all been on the ground. It's been using up clock. And it's all well and good if they can score here, Coach, but at some point they're going to have to put that ball in the air. Third and short, as he was short, as you said. Fern gives the handoff to number 24, and he's stacked up after gaining the first down. That was Stone Peary, a sophomore.
It's a nice tackle, just to gain a yard. Give them the first down, but.
And now you're out of room. First and goal from the 9 yard line upcoming here. We'll see if Chanute can bend but not break. This looks pretty similar to Pittsburgh's first drive, Coach, where just solid run game down the field. Webb Fern now with a little pitch to the left side as the running back cuts it back. He maybe got a couple. Second and goal upcoming from about the 6.
That quarterback's holding that ball till he gets smacked and then pitching.
Oh, man, that's dangerous, Coach. You keep waiting for that. Boy, he waits a split second too long, and that's going to be a disaster. But so far, they've been living on that edge and doing pretty well on this drive. That option is so – you're living on a razor's edge sometimes. Second and goal from the 6. Fern, now fake, now the pitch to the right. He's got some room. Can he get it up there? No. Touchdown saving tackle by Quinton Harding. Now a late flag
comes in.
We'll see what this flag's about. It's right there where the tackle was made. The ball's placed at the 2 yard line, and it is a hold on Pittsburgh. So a late hold too, and that's gonna send Pittsburgh back, conceivably to the 12 yard line, if that's where the penalty happened, where the flag was thrown. That is where the spot's gonna be.
That's being in the fourth quarter, starting to wear down to make choice like that. You're tired.
Well, the play was over.
Yeah, that's what you don't.
Like, the play was over. You had a good shot. The running back gave it a good shot, and Quinton Harding made a good tackle. But, yeah, the play was over there. So that's a bad penalty for Pittsburgh. It's second and goal now from the 12.
I wonder if they dive it left.
Fern fakes the handoff and tries to run with it, but this time he's hit by Dagan Dean and finished off by Trey Dillo. And it's going to bring up third and goal from the 10. Almost certainly a four-down territory here for Pittsburgh in situation. Down by 3 scores with under 10 minutes to go. Another flag on the field.
As many tackles as Dean's made all night, how do you keep running towards him?
And another hold on Pittsburgh as this just went from bad to worse for the Purple Dragons. So they'll send him back again, and it's going to be spotted at the 19-yard line. So that hold took place 3 yards down past the line of scrimmage. They didn't even get close to that, Coach. What's going on? So second down and goal from the 19 now. Here is Webb Fern as he pitches out to the left. Now the running back's got a room, cuts it up all the way down to near the goal line and the 1 yard line. And boy, that was good play for Pittsburgh. As
if he held it any longer, he was sacked.
So third and goal now from the 1, as all those penalties are made up for by 1 run. The 1 yard line, we'll see if Pittsburgh just runs a little dive action here.
Leedy made a saving tackle on that play.
Webb Fern under center. Will he keep it? He does not. He gives to the first back through, and it's an easy touchdown for the Purple Dragons. And so it's a little bit closer now, 28-13. Pittsburgh's going to have to do something they haven't been able to do all night, though, Coach, and that is stop Chanute on offense. Kicker out on the field for Pittsburgh, Jackson McKechnie, for his second PAT of the night. Snap is down. The kick is blocked. The kick is blocked. I think that was Quinton Harding that got in there. He got a piece of that ball. Blocked extra point. So it stays 28-13. 8:46 to go. We'll be right back. 8:46 to go here in the game. Chanute leads 28-13. Coach, too early for an onside kick?
Nope, not down by 14.
I was going to say, man, I don't know how good you're feeling about getting a stop when you really need one here.
So you got to get the ball back.
We'll see what they have dialed up here.
Our coaches must have thought it. We've moved our four that we have back into three up close because last week they did it.
McKechnie runs forward here. We'll see what he does. It is a go-ahead and deep kick taken by Leedy. Leedy drops it, picks it back up. Now he's running forward. Well, that wasn't Leedy, was it? That was number 11 in there, Chris Harding. So the hands team has a different deep man. That is freshman Chris Harding getting a little action there. 5'11", 155-pounder. The hands team.
Nice.
Now he's in the
score. He must have built some trust in the coach going as the freshman.
Hey, man, he's in the stats now.
Yep.
A sideline warning on the Blue Comets. Everyone scoots back. Yeah, just got a little excited. It was like dinner time at the Rimbold house. You know what I'm saying? Everyone's just creeping forward, like, oh, all right. First down and 10. Upcoming here from the 27-yard line. Well, oh, no, now we're respawning. Make it to 28. Why not?
I haven't seen the football be moved so many times after it's set.
I'm telling you what. I didn't want to say anything. You said it, Coach.
You can blame it on me.
Now we got another stoppage as we get a new football in there. Well, we didn't like that old football anyways. So going to eventually run that first down play. A nice little underhanded toss by the ref there. Pretty spiral. Like Dan
That's
Marino.
That's called the official or the coach's toss.
They called him the underhanded Dan Marino in his prime. Herb in the gun. Here's Pittsburgh showing blitz. He's back to pass. Little quick pass. Oh, dangerous.
That was a dangerous one.
Miscommunication there as Dillo maybe was on a different page than Herb. Maybe it was a good thing. He might have gotten his head ripped off. Second down and 10, and boy, that was the about the.
I don't think he had time because that was a crossing pattern, and Dean was going to go deep. Dillo was going to set, and they both set on Dillo like because he's the one been getting it. Had we had any time, Herb would have thrown that deeper.
That was the roughest play of the night on offense for Chanute.
Almost every linebacker.
So second down and 10 upcoming. Now here is the handoff to Leedy, who's got a little room. Dragging defenders again. Again, it's still rolling.
Holy
first down, Leedy. Well, he just never stops.
165 pounds carrying four guys, 7 yards.
I mean, what a force of nature Ty Leedy is. He comes off the field for a rest. I guess you can't blame him. My goodness.
Playing middle linebacker and tailback all night.
So first and 10 from their 40 is Chanute, and precious seconds will continue to click off for the Pittsburgh Purple Dragons. Herb in the shotgun. As always, here's the snap. Here comes the blitz again. Harding's going to have to make a move just to get out of the backfield, and he can't do it.
Five are having a hard time stopping six.
So Pittsburgh is bringing the blitz, and Chanute committed to playing it pretty conservative here and letting the clock run. We'll see if they uncork one. They haven't really done what we're accustomed to seeing them do, which is take some deep chances. We haven't seen it all game. It's been pretty impressive, actually, Coach, to watch them just kind of methodically move down the field. But you keep wondering if one of these plays they're going to do it. Trips to the near side. Here's the snap. Herb back to pass. Boy, he's got lots of time. Now he tucks it down. He's going to try and run with the ball. Defenders went for the ball, and Herb is wrestled down across the 40.
One thing the Purple Dragons have done, Dave, that they weren't doing before half, is the outside's getting up, closing that circle off to get pressure, where if when Herb has to run, he's got to go up the middle, and there's a linebacker waiting for him.
Yeah, third down and long is what's going to happen here. Third down and about eight. So we'll see what Chanute dials up here. As the clock runs, under 7 minutes to go here in the game. And this will get interesting here, Coach, if they can't get this first down and have to punt this ball back. Two scores is a little bit more doable. Big play for Pittsburgh. Here is the snap. Here comes the screen. It seems to drops another one. Oh, my goodness. Boy, Caden was going to run for a long ways there.
That's like the one in the first quarter. He was coming across the middle, and it went through his hands.
So now Chanute in a situation where you would think there might be a punt upcoming. They line it up quick.
I bet you they quick kick it.
That's what they've been known to do in the past, is a little quick kick. But Herb is a little bit shorter. He's going to try and draw him offside. Now back up. That's when you know that punt's coming. Here is the snap. The kick by Herb is a good one. And, boy, this takes the right kind of bounce. And it is going to be good for Chanute if it slows up. And it does. Woo! Downed at the two-yard line. What a kick. There is a flag in the backfield.
Man, hopefully that's roughing the kicker. Because that's trick on the kicker, that's our ball.
Well, the officials are moving down the field, so.
Maybe they picked it up.
Well, I'd say maybe they did pick it up. He put the flag in his pocket, and he is not making a move to tell us what it was for. So that was his flag, too. That was the head official. He just picked it up and
so
moved
on. So he
voted
on his own.
Yeah, I guess so. That's kind of weird.
Oh, it was a personal foul against the Purple Dragons. Half of the distance to the goal line when you're on the two.
He kind of made that call walking. That was weird. I'm still not quite sure what happened. Now the coach, Coach Cleet Frizzell, wants a little dialogue with the official.
Because it's on the kicker.
The official did an air punch. I guess. I don't know exactly what I'm seeing, but.
Elbow to the helmet.
He's modeling apparently what he saw, so.
Frizzell was wanting the ball back.
He called it a dead ball, but the flag was way down here. How could that have been a dead ball? The flag was the 50-yard line.
Oh, they're bringing it back. That coach.
Oh, it's on Chanute. Okay. Well, that would have been better information about 20 seconds ago. Okay, so they mark it off at the end of the play there.
In the personal foul, they only gave him 10 yards. That's a 15-yard foul.
Yeah, now the whistles are happening because the other officials have just realized that. Boy, this has been a rough night.
Hey, they're going to stay with it.
The officials are human too, so we'll see. Now that ball was down to the two, so.
And it's on the 17.
They're on the right spot. It's just a weird circumstances here. Here's a run up the middle for Pittsburgh. Boy, here's a Pittsburgh player blocking about. Well, he wasn't down. Well, I thought he was down. At least his forward progress was stopped.
He was like Liddy. He kept his feet moving.
Okay.
There was only one guy on him. That he wasn't three or four.
Second down and four after a gain of six that kind of happened in camouflage. Under six to play here. Pittsburgh still got a chance, but they're going to have to move quickly. Quicker than they're moving now, for sure. Here's Webb Fern back to pass over the middle. Down the seam is caught. And immediately Quinton Harding hits him, but it's going to be a first down for Pittsburgh.
Both Will Linebacker and Mike Ryan, Linebacker read it. They were just one step from picking that off. Went right over, hit Leedy's hand.
Under five and a half to go. Pittsburgh not showing any sort of intensity or need to hurry here. Webb Fern under center. First down from the 37. He gives to the first man through, who's trying to keep his feet moving this time. Gain of about four or so. And the clock will continue to run.
How long are they going to be able to continue to run this?
And they've got three timeouts. So I would guess they're going to try and save those for a defensive possession. But they're not hurrying out of the huddle. They're taking a full huddle time.
Purple Dragons
And they did that fast offense right before half, so they do have it in their arsenal.
Second down and six for Pittsburgh at their own 42. Fern hands off to the running back off tackle, who makes a couple guys miss. Well, I'll tell you what, if they can get back in this game, it has been almost fully on the hands of Wyatt Rink, who is turned into a mini, another version of Ty Leedy out there. 5'7" junior, and he has been running well here in the second half for the Purple Dragons. But again, we're two plays later and another minute gone off the clock. We're under 4.5 here.
And you're down two touchdowns.
And it's first down from just across midfield now. Pittsburgh back to pass. Now he's being chased out of the pocket.
And
he's going to go down. Dagan Dean again. Dagan Dean Weaver.
That was worth it.
Second sack of the night.
9-yard loss. They're going to mark it at 8.
Second sack of the night, says stat man Hunter Schwegman from the Chanute Tribune. And there's 4:05 left to go and a timeout called.
That might be the registered second sack, but he has killed that quarterback probably 8 or 9 times that just the ball had gotten out of his hand.
Well, and it's just the core 3 quarterback pressures
in one drive.
Yeah, this is and maybe, you know, we've been talking about, like, hey, they're not passing the ball, but then they go back to pass, and then that happens, and then maybe you're seeing why Pittsburgh feels like they can't pass the ball. And it's not like that they can't, they just can't give them enough time. Dagan Dean is in that backfield almost immediately after the snap, and poor Webb Fern running for his life.
And we're not sending our backers, like, they're having to send their backers.
Yeah, so
we're still having a safe defense where be interesting if the defensive coordinator started to send some linebackers. At least one.
So we'll see what Pittsburgh can dial up here. Like, once again, thank our underwriters of KFEX and Firescape Youth Ministry. Labette Health, Dr. Grant Gastineau, Home Savings Bank, Cleaver Farm and Home, Medicine Shop, Community National Bank, Cardinal Drugstore, Jared Gilmore and Phillips. Thank you for your support of specifically underwriting these partnerships we do with the tech classes here at Chanute High School. Everything you're seeing, all the camera work being done by these high school students. So second down and 17, 4:07. Webb Fern under center, and we got movement on the line. This might be offsides, as I saw a defensive lineman for Chanute jump.
Was he drawn? We'll see.
That'll be the question. We'll see what the referees decide. Might have been a little movement by the left guard. But we'll see what the referees decide here. This is one of those meetings that could have been an email, I think, right? It is encroachment. So they decide that it was the Chanute player, and he was not drawn off. So 5-yard penalty brings up second down and 12. And we'll do it over. Webb Fern and Wyatt Rink in the backfield. Fern keeps it on a quarterback option, now turns it up the field and gets hammered after a gain of about 4.
Coach sent the right linebacker on that one. He just barely missed the quarterback.
Big hit again by Quentin Harding. Gets up slow. This time it's going to be a hold on Pittsburgh, the penalty. So now penalty on Pittsburgh, and that's an absolute killer for them. Boy, Quentin Harding, it's hard not to notice him, this young man on defense. He is all over the field, and boy, he doesn't just wrap you up. I mean, you're going to take a hit.
We talked about him a lot last year. He played a lot on special teams. We kept wondering if he'd make it. When he would get in, he would play linebacker. It's neat he found a spot at safety where he gets to run up and smash.
Yeah, every time he's been on tackle, you've known it.
Yep.
Second down and 22 upcoming here for the Purple Dragons. Fern back to pass. Lobs it out
nice.
There for his receivers, and there he is.
That was
number
great
three,
coverage,
Eric Herb,
play.
The quarterback up there to make the play on defense.
Herb and Dillo were there. He wasn't getting out.
That'll bring up third and long. It's Pittsburgh running out of chances here. We're down under 3.5 to play. And again, I can't help but notice the lack of urgency for Pittsburgh. And maybe this is just having a young team, or should they be beyond that?
You'd think they would have a few plays to try to get in the game, being all juniors and a few seniors.
So Pittsburgh with two wide receivers now. And now the whistles are blown, and we're going to get a timeout. Boy, then the Pittsburgh coach was out on the field there yelling at his players before the officials could even signal it, so he was not happy. Man, we'll just keep it right here. Let's go back to that question, Coach. Pittsburgh taking a lot of time in between plays. They're down two scores. This is not a bad team, Coach. They've played admirably here tonight. Is youth a problem in trying to hurry up your offense?
I think it goes back to, does the quarterback have the time to – it might be the youth and the receivers. Maybe the coach don't trust throwing it deep because they've only thrown short balls.
Yeah, it's situational, though.
Yeah.
Because there's certainly been teams that, you know, had a lot of juniors playing where you could get a hurry-up offense. But for whatever reason, Pittsburgh just – maybe the coaches don't feel like they can do that right now with them. So.
And that might be set up by how much pressure we've put on them all night.
Yeah, well, certainly they feel hamstrung about how much they can drop back Webb Fern to pass because of the pressure being put on by Dagan Dean, who's been a one-man wrecking crew on that defensive line from the defensive end position.
So he keeps saying both his names, and it's like he's two people out there.
So 2:55 to go, 3rd and 22, big play upcoming.
Maybe we got Irv going to blitz from this backside.
Here's the snap, and boy, the defense all over the quarterback, and they're there for the pitch out and a gain of maybe two. And great defensive play, and that brings up 4th and a prayer now for Pittsburgh if they want to keep their hopes alive.
It's nice to see your quarterback who's playing corner come all the way from the backside. He don't make the play, but he don't give up, and he's been on the field all night.
And do we have another timeout?
No,
or is this a flag?
There's a flag on the field.
Oh, my goodness.
And it was after the play was dead.
Well, I wait for the white hat to tell us the call, which he may get around to. Oh, he's writing in his book. That's a bad one.
It's one of those marked ones.
It is. Oh, my. Unsportsmanlike penalty on Chanute, and that is going to be bad. That's on Canton Fitzmaurice, the sophomore.
Getting some playing time with 2 minutes left.
Is this an automatic first down, Coach?
Yes, sir.
Oh, my. My goodness. So you went from a place where this game is.
Give it to, they were back far enough. It isn't. It's 1 yard.
Okay, so it's 4th down and 1, but that's an much more doable proposition for Pittsburgh, and the door remains open just a tiny bit here for the Purple Dragons.
Goodness, swear.
Well, wow, what a huge play that was. I'm sure the coaches for Chanute will not let that one go by in video.
No.
It was number 5 with the penalty. So it was Caden Seamster with the penalty, not 55. Caden's had a rough night.
Yeah, some of that frustration of dropping passes starts to come to you when you don't do that, when you're not used to that.
So 4th down and 1. Well, it's a game where you're running around and hitting each other and the adrenaline's flowing. Certainly it happens sometimes. You lose control a little bit, and it can definitely happen on a football field.
I'd like to see our linebackers up right on our D-line's tail end right here.
4th down and 1. Webb Fern.
Dive.
Now, oh, boy.
They had
now
it.
He hit it to sticks. And
it'll
a flag.
It's going to be an interesting.
Well, flag came in on the hit. That'll be interesting to see what they're going to call there.
Well, this official's gaining ground as he's walking across the field.
It looked like it'll be a first down without the penalty.
He was clean back at the 40.
Boy, that flag came flying in there right after the hit on the runner. It looked like a clean hit from here from our vantage point. It is illegal helmet contact. Oh, my goodness.
So is that helmet to helmet?
That's two penalties a row, keeping the door open for Pittsburgh. 2:17 to go, and another personal foul, this time on a big hit by the defense.
Well, their coach isn't setting any urgency for them, but we're helping.
Yeah, the clock continues to run here, by the way. 2:10 now and counting.
So D's got to just hold them and let the clock keep ticking.
But it's first down and 10 for Pittsburgh. Here is Fern Webb. He's back passing. To passing. He's over the middle, and it's dropped by the receiver. Boy, he had it.
That was a nice pass in between three defenders. That should have been a touchdown. It was in his hands.
Yeah, that one's one he wishes he could get back there, as that should have been six for Pittsburgh. But a drop pass. We've seen a few drop passes tonight. Hasn't been a clean game for either team.
Yeah, I was going to say both ways.
And second down and 10. Boy, that was a great ball delivered by Webb Fern.
We can't fall asleep on that veer option.
And here is Fern under center. He's back and gives to that first man through, who's been running good here in the second half. Wyatt Rink. Maybe that was someone else there on that run. It's been Wyatt Rink most of the half. Pittsburgh now hurrying up to the line a little bit, as we're going to be under a minute and a half on this play. Third down and short. Webb back to pass. Now he's out of the pocket, and he's almost wrapped up.
How is that not?
We got a flag on the hole on the floor on the field, though, I believe.
Should have been the white hat, though. Dean was.
Oh no, that is not a flag. That was just a random piece of something out there. So it's fourth down and very short. Fourth and one. Big play. Now the fake pitch. Now pass out to the left, and good breakdown and tackle as the clock will continue to run. Pittsburgh may use that last time out here. No, they will not. The clock will stop to move the sticks at 1 minute to go, 60 seconds. Chanute leads 28-13, but the clock is running again. Here is Webb Fern, back to pass. This one is floated, almost picked off. Some miscommunication between the quarterback and the receiver. And that'll stop the clock with 49 seconds to go.
Had Herb not had the dive, he'd have been running that one back 98 yards.
So second down and 10 now from the 12-yard line for Pittsburgh. And Pittsburgh just
still having a hard time sitting here wondering where their need to score was.
Well, they're playing, they're playing a pretty good fourth quarter. They've won the fourth quarter.
Sure.
But, yeah, they're just running out of time. Webb Fern back to pass. And this one's lobbed up in the air and out of bounds.
I wonder if the coach is trying to build and sit for next week. Build on.
Oh, now we got another late flag. Well, what was this about? Oh, now he just threw his hat?
That's the second flag.
Oh, my goodness gracious.
Somebody's coming off the field.
Oh, my goodness gracious. Chanute shooting themselves in the foot here.
And that'll affect him for 2 weeks if that is both of those on one kid.
Wait for the officials to sort this out, but Chanute just kind of self-destructing here a little bit here in the final minutes of this game. A lot of after the play penalties, and that was clearly a case of he's saying something to the official that he shouldn't have. And you're about to win this game. You're up 28-13, less than a minute to go.
Yeah, you got to let some of that stuff. That'll get addressed in the film room, too.
Oh, okay. Well, it's one of those offsetting jobs there. So, okay.
So had we not talked back, though, we'd be backing them up 15 yards.
Well, we saw some chippiness early in the game, Coach, but we hadn't really seen it lately, but some frustrations pouring out here, which, again, look.
That's football.
Competitive, man. You get competitive kids out there, but you got to stop the mouth. The Bible says the tongue is like a fire. Mm-hmm. You got to, if you control nothing else, control the tongue.
Sure.
So 43 seconds to go. Second down and 10 from the 12 for Pittsburgh. And Webb firm under center. He's back to pass again. Here comes the rush. Dean almost got to him. Now it steps up. He's got one man to beat. He shakes the tackle, floss the football, and Chanute's got it. Well, that'll end the game. Well, that's the way it should happen, I guess, Coach.
That puts an exclamation point on it. And that's beaten Pittsburgh 2 years in a row.
I didn't see who recovered it. Leedy forced it. Oh, no, that was Trey Dillo. He forced it and recovered it. That was Trey Dillo on the force and the recovery. So, and poor Webb Fern. Let's give it up for the Pittsburgh quarterback. He's just trying to make something, just giving that extra effort. And, boy, how many times do you see it in the game of football?
He definitely has to be the player of the game for their team when you vote one. Even though you lose, you vote a player of the game. Yeah. And he has to earn that.
Yeah. He carried him in the first half. And the second half, he got some help from Wyatt Rink, his junior cohort. But Pittsburgh going to come up short to Chanute. The Blue Dragons, I get them confused. That was a little dyslexic there, but it's the Blue Comets and the Purple Dragons. The blue in front of the mascot, colors in front of the mascot throw me off. So the victory formation here for Chanute is they will kneel it down, and this will be the end of the ball game. I wouldn't expect to see Pittsburgh call timeout, use that last timeout, unless they want some interesting games next year. Nope, they will not, and that'll do it. The Blue Comets are going to win this one 28-13. Coach, it was at times a rough game for Chanute in some fashions. Pittsburgh, let's give them credit. They managed to keep the big play off the field. Chanute used to getting those big plays, and when they did bust off a big play, it was through their legs.
It is. It's weird not to see us open one up to get the running game, but it was nice to see getting 28 points.
Yeah.
And passing at will. I agree that we have to give Pittsburgh their due. They had their heads held up. I mean, fighting that fourth quarter, like you said, they took the whole fourth quarter from us, run the ball until losing the ball on the 5 yard line.
Well, honestly, when it was 28-7, we just thought they couldn't stop Chanute.
Right.
Up to that point, they hadn't been able to stop them, and then in the fourth quarter, they put the clamps down on them. Now, I think, it's probably a little of both. Pittsburgh did a good job of being solid on defense, and maybe Chanute took their foot off the pedal a little bit, trying to take the air out of the football a little too much. But you give Pittsburgh the credit. In the end, they just couldn't operate with the speed that was necessary, partially because they couldn't drop back and throw the ball. And that's where we give Chanute credit, and especially Dagan Dean. I don't know who you're going to give your defensive game ball to. I wish I could chop it in half, because Quentin Hardy is becoming someone you can't ignore on the field. The sophomore safety for Chanute and running back, 5'10", 171 pounds. Man, he's just all over the field, and when he makes the tackle or the hit, you know it. Like, he leaves a memory for the guy he's tackling.
And he's coming from 12 yards back.
Yeah. I mean, he's laying some wood out there. But I think you got to give the defensive game ball to Dagan Dean.
You have to, because we had three pressures in one series. We had two sacks.
Well, he just changed the game. Because Pittsburgh, that's why Pittsburgh couldn't operate with the urgency they really needed, the speed they really needed to do that. They had to keep running the ball, because every time they dropped back, Dagan was in there just causing havoc.
Who are you going to go with offense?
Man, well, I don't know. Offensively, a lot of guys had good games. I kind of want to give it to Trey Dillo.
That's what I think. His second week with the touchdown and the first touchdown of the game.
And listen, you could give it to Herb every game.
For sure.
I mean, he's a smart quarterback. He's solid. He leads the team. Statistically, he probably had the best game on the offense. But, man, Trey Dillo does the things that – so you got the two guys on the outside, and Seamster and Dagan Dean, who get to get the glory. They get the long balls. They get those slants. You're asking Trey Dillo to go in there, sit down in the middle of that zone, take some punishment, but be solid with the football. And tonight he scored a touchdown. And I think, I think I would give Trey Dillo the game ball offensively tonight.
He's the Welker of the Chanute Comet.
There you go. Yeah.
The guy that has to sit down in the middle and take the hits.
Yeah. And he was great tonight. And
he played a great defensive game also.
Yeah, well, absolutely. Trey Dillo, defensively, we've said this for the last two seasons now, just seems to be all over the field. He's another one of those guys. He always seems to be in the tackle, right? He always seems to be near the football. And, Trey Dillo, you like to see a kid get the touchdown, you know, get that reward because he doesn't. He's often not the guy who's the deep ball. Right. But, yeah, what a game for him tonight. And, yeah, good stuff. The Chanute moves to 2-0 on the season. And, you know, quite frankly, maybe their toughest two opponents here early in the season. And they made it look, for the most part, pretty easy tonight.
I think our line looks great. And coach is doing awesome building that. Mm-hmm. The run came together, which we didn't see last week. And our tackling's, I think we got to bring our special teams up to that, to the standard where our offense and defensive are, because that's where we lost more yards than.
Yeah, it's the best kind of 2-0 you could be, right, Coach? Because you didn't dominate. There's still a lot of things we can spot in the video room and we can work on in practice. So you get to keep them. You get to kind of let them, like, go home, be glad you won. But then tomorrow, let's come back and watch the video, watch the tape, and let's get back to work, because we got a lot of room for improvement.
And then
We haven't played a perfect game.
No. That makes it nice to keep your kids down, keeps them not getting too big ahead.
Yeah. And so
looking ahead.
A lot of season left, but boy, what a great start for Chanute. They are 2-0, and this is exciting. This is going to be an exciting season. Stick around. This is going to be a fun ride.
Keep coming with us, whether you travel or you watch us on YouTube and listen to Dave and I.
Yeah, thank you so much for tuning in to Comet Vision. This is a Comet Vision KFEX partnership. We're part of the Firescape Youth Ministry. Love to work with the kids. Everything you're seeing out on the field here in this stream, the cameras, it's all being operated by the students of the tech class here, run by Mr. Caleb Wood. And so big shout out to all the kids who are doing, and they're doing the production work. They're in the trailer. They're doing their thing. So,
and it's live,
and they're troubleshooting, and there's all sorts of technical things going wrong back here that they're having to try and solve on the fly. So, you know, we had some technical difficulties last week, and we got some of those shored up. And then there's, you know, another figurative fire, you know, to put out, not a literal one, thank goodness. But this is a partnership that we love to do with them. We would like to, shout out our underwriters that make it possible for us to be here. Labette Health, Dr. Grant Gastineau, Home Savings Bank, Cleaver Farm and Home, The Medicine Shop, Community National Bank, Cardinal Drug, Jared Gilmore, Phillips PA, Alert Construction, Shields Motors, Living Word Assembly, and A&W. I could use a cheeseburger right now. That's what I'm saying.
That sounds good.
All right. For Chad Graham and for Mr. Caleb Wood, the teacher of the Chanute Tech classes, and all the high school students in this operation, thank you so much for watching. We'll see you next Friday.